Let's try this. What's going on, Facebook? Come on in. Come on in. Hope you're having a good day. Happy Sunday to you. I'm sharing this to a couple pages, giving you a come on in. Got something to share with you today. Hope you're ready. Hope you're ready. Be ready. Be ready. Come with expectation. Hello, welcome. Come on in. Come on in. Sharing this to a couple places. Welcome to Weekly Wisdom. Today we're going to talk about wonderfully complex. Hey, Mom. Hey, Teresa. How you all doing this wonderful Sunday? Talk about us today, how we're wonderfully complex. Would you agree that you are complex? Sometimes that's why people can't understand us. Sometimes that's why people can't really be, they don't know how to relate to us because we are wonderfully complex. We're going to talk about that for a minute. Hey, Keisha, what's going on? Good to see you. Good to see you. Welcome, welcome. Waiting on all my complex people to join me today so we can talk about this thing. Hope you all are doing well. Share this if you would. I've shared it a couple places. Let's let the world get this message. We're going to share it. We're going to keep on expanding our reach, expanding our territory. Prayer of Jabez said, Lord, expand our territory. Thank you, Teresa. You have made a declaration that is absolutely true. You are complex, complex. I know that can have multiple meanings. I know we can look at that a couple of different ways. We can have different perceptions for what that means and how that determines how others can interact with us. We are complex beings. We're complex. We're complicated. We're complicated. And so we're going to talk about that. Hey, Lysandra, how you doing? How you doing? Happy Sunday to you. Welcome, welcome, welcome. All right, I see enough of us here. I want to get right into this thing today. Y'all ready? You ready? You ready? Thank you, Keisha. Yep, I'm doing well. We're doing well down here in Tennessee, doing the best we can with what we got. And we're happy to be here with an opportunity to share something with you that can potentially help your life to go better so that you can reach further, you can dig deeper, you can climb higher, you can succeed and achieve those goals that you've been wondering about and wanting to reach and desiring to attain. Today is an opportunity for us to be able to pour into you so that you can go further, so that you can do more, so that you can climb higher, so that you can stand on the shoulders, so that you don't have to experience everything that I've experienced in order to get to where you're trying to go with less friction, with less resistance, with less things fighting against you. Lysandra, you said you're complex. Yeah, we are complex, complex beings. So I want to share a passage of scripture with you today from Psalm, the 139th number of Psalm. I'm going to read several verses today, verses 13 through 18. I know a lot of times I only give you a little bit to chew on. We usually look at like one or two verses. So it's a few more verses today to look at. But I want us to look at 13 through 18 in the 139th number of the book of Psalms. David is talking and he says this. He says, "You made all the delicate inner parts of my body and knit me together in my mother's womb. Thank you for making me so wonderfully complex. Your workmanship is marvelous. How well I know it. You watched me as I was being formed in utter seclusion, as I was woven together in the dark of the womb. You saw me before I was born. Every day of my life was recorded in your book. Every moment was laid out before a single day had passed. How precious are your thoughts about me, O God. They cannot be numbered. I can't even count them. They outnumber the grains of sand. And when I wake up, you are still with me." That passage of scripture is so powerful to me. But one of the things that it keys in on that I definitely want to talk with you about a little bit today in my time that I have with you, David declared that he was fearfully, the King James, NIV, the NLT, several versions say it like this: he was fearfully and wonderfully made. And I want to say that about you as well today. In spite of what others may think, in spite of the misperceptions that people might have about you, in spite of the misperceptions that you might even have about yourself, I need you to understand that you were fearfully and wonderfully made. This concept is one that I think about quite often. This passage that I chose the version, the New Living Translation. And I love how he says it. He says, "Thank you, God, for making me so wonderfully complex." Many times we don't thank God for our complexity. As a matter of fact, many times we feel that our complexity is a negative. We feel that our complexity is what causes us to have many of the issues and the problems that we have. But how boring it would be if we were just simple, if we were one-faceted, if we were monofaceted. Instead, we are multifaceted. We are polyfaceted, if you will. We have many different sides to us as a creation. We were fearfully and wonderfully made. Now, the complexity of us really doesn't speak so much to us because I didn't make me. The complexity of you doesn't really, it's not really an attribute or something that you can take credit for or that you can accept blame for. Oh, man. And many times we begin to blame ourselves for our complexity and we begin to minimize the beauty of our complexity. But the fact of the matter is that the complexity of the creation has very little to do with what has been created and very much to do with who created it. Any great artist that makes a complex, beautiful piece that has many meanings and that can be interpreted from one generation to the next generation in different ways, it was not the creation that deserves the credit for the beauty that it has in it, the complexity that it has in it, the meaning that it has in it. But instead, it is the creator who begins to get credit for the beauty, for the complexity, for the meaning, for the symbolism. Oh, man, for the power, for how it will overtake you. And when you look at it, it will cause you to gasp. It will cause a biological reaction. It will cause a tear to fall from your eyes because you're looking at the wonder and the beauty and the awe of the creation. But the creation is a product, is a manipulation of the creator. The creator is who creates the beauty and the wonder of the art that causes the breathlessness, that causes the wow factor, that causes the awe, and it causes the, oh my, it causes those exclamations that are an outpour of the joy of the experience of taking in the beauty of the complexity of the creation. It is really an attribute of the author. It is really an attribute of the creator. It is really an attribute of the artist. And so you are made by the master craftsman. You were developed and created by the master artist. Oh my goodness, I'm feeling my help real good today. You were created by one who understands the depths of creation, by one who is limitless in scope, by one who is omniscient, has all science. Omniscient, science, has all understanding of how things work, of how pieces go together, of what can be arranged in the right place. You are the product of the master craftsman, the potter, if you will. The potter has molded the clay and put you together just as you were intended to be built. I know you don't feel like you're living out the intention. I know you don't see the beauty of it, because when we look at ourselves, we don't see the complexity. We don't don't see the complex nature. We don't see the significance of the fact that we have all the right things in all the right places to accomplish all of the right agenda that we have been sent and purposed on this earth to accomplish. But I'm here to tell you today that you were fearfully and wonderfully made, that you are magnificently complex, that you were made out of complexity. You are wonderfully complex. Somebody type it again. I'm wonderfully complex. I'm wonderfully complex. Yeah, the fact that you see the world different than some of the other people around you is because you are wonderfully complex. The fact that you experience life in ways that are different even than where you came from shows that you are wonderfully complex. The fact that you're able to keep on getting up even though life keeps on trying to knock you down reveals to us that you have been designed by a craftsman who gave you the ability to bounce back in a way that shows your art, in a way that shows your complexity, in a way that shows that there's something more to you than what meets the eye. You are wonderfully complex. You are wonderfully complex. You are amazing. You were made by the master craftsman. Therefore, you are a masterpiece. You are a piece of the master. You are a reflection of the mind that created you. I think I've been thinking a lot this week about how art is developed, about how inventions are developed, about how things come to be in this earth. And everything that was created, and I'm still biblical, I could take you to the verse if I needed to, but I think you might trust me. Everything that was created by an artist first existed in the mind of that artist. Oh my goodness. Every business, every building, every house, everything that was sculpted, everything that was crafted, everything that was constructed, everything that was birthed, everything that exists in this world first began in the mind of an author. So we first existed in the mind of God before we existed in the world of God. Oh yeah. And then he caused what existed in his mind to enter into the chambers, into the potter's oven, into the process of birthing what existed first in his mind. He brought it through the channel of your mother and your father, and you ended up in a womb, and you came out of that womb, birthed into a particular family, into a particular home, in a particular neighborhood, in a particular city, in a particular state, in a particular region. He fine-tuned and pinpointed exactly where you would be needed at precisely the time that you would be needed there. And he crafted you and he weaved into you what was needed in order to accomplish his mission, his plan, his objective, his will for not only your life, but for the places that he has put you in. Oh my goodness. So we look at the scripture and it says in verse 13 of the 139th number of Psalm, it says, "You made all the delicate inner parts of my body." You made all the delicate inner parts, the parts you can't see, even beyond the skin and the organs and the tissue. You made my emotional makeup. God has crafted you exactly how he wanted to craft you. He gave you the mindset that you have. Oh yeah, I know you think that you corrupted it along the way. You may not be using it the way that he has identified for it to be used. And that's where we shift and get back into the purpose and plan of God. But he made you the way you are on purpose. You are that way. You feel what you feel on purpose. You see what you see on purpose, on purpose. Somebody type, "I'm living on purpose. I'm on purpose." I know the world might have told you that you were an accident. I've heard something like that before about me because I was 10 years after my next sibling. I know that people sometimes think that you are on purpose, but God had a specific complex plan with you in mind. You are on purpose. Now it's time, because you're on purpose, to begin to shift your circumstances and your situation so that you're not only on purpose, but you begin to live in purpose. Today is your day to live in purpose. Why? Because you are wonderfully complex. There's something that you can do that nobody else can do the way that you can do it, because nobody has your swag, your style, your flavor, or your flow. So the verse continues, you made all the delicate inner parts of me, the stuff that is vulnerable. Yeah, delicate inner parts, the stuff that hurts me. You made that in me, the stuff that I care about, my passions. You made that in me. You poured it into me even before I was formed in my mother's womb. You began to create me. You created what was needed for where I was about to go. Even before time existed, you had a plan for me. And I'm here to tell you today that before time existed, before you existed on this earth, you existed in the mind of God, and he had a plan for you, an intricate plan and a complex plan. And he began even then to put in you what was needed. He saw the substance of you, and he began to weave the substance of you, and he began to put attributes of him in you. The artist always pours a piece of themselves into the creation. The creator always puts a piece of the creator in the creation. And so you were built to be like him in some particular way. And our purpose is a process of finding, what is it about me that is like him? What is it about me that can accomplish what he has accomplished? How can I create like he created? What can I create on my microcosm level that will be reflective of what he has created in his story, history. And we are a part of his story. And it's your job to begin to make his story complete. You are here to make his story. You are here to make history. Somebody type it. I'm here to make history. I'm here to make history. I'm here to change the world. I'm here to change my sphere of influence. I'm here to make a mark. I'm here to make a difference. I'm here to leave a legacy. I'm here to make history. I'm here. Is anybody here to make history? Do I have any world changers, any trendsetters, any trailblazers who say it might not have been done before me, but it's about to be done through me? Oh God, I feel my help real good today. There's some people today, you've been called to do what you haven't even seen, and you're beginning to see some things existing in your mind. Vision. Somebody type vision. You're seeing some vision. You're beginning to see some things existing in your mind that you've never seen exist in your neighborhood. You're beginning to see some things exist in your mind that never existed in your family. You are about to climb on the shoulders of them who came before you and go higher. You're about to accomplish something that you would have no handbook for, that no one has shown you what it looks like. God is calling you to do more. He's calling you to change the trajectory of your family, to change the trajectory of your neighborhood, to change the trajectory of your city, to change the trajectory of your world. There is a greater calling in you. How do I know it? Because he made you wonderfully complex. And now you have to begin to pull the complexity out of you and begin to let the complexity be seen, and begin to let the complexity make a difference in your world. He said, you made all the delicate inner parts of my body. And then look at this next part. And you knit me together in my mother's womb. Now, my mother is a knitter. My mother, who's on here right now, I grew up watching her knit. She tried to teach me how to knit several times. I didn't have the patience because I would look at the process and what she would do with those knitting needles, and she would begin to wrap it around and to twist it and to pull it under and to tuck it and to pull it just the right way, to the point where it was happening effortlessly and flawlessly. And she was weaving together the pieces that at the beginning it looked like it couldn't be anything. The furthest I ever got was I made a pot holder because it was a small square. But I would see her begin to keep on going, and that pot holder would turn into a sweater, and that sweater would turn into a dress or a purse. And I would begin to see that she would know how to knit the fabric together. Now, this text, David begins to tell us that what happened while you were in your mother's womb is that God God began to knit together your substance, the substance of who you are, and he began to knit that together with his substance. He began to have a collaboration. Oh yeah, y'all know I've been talking about this. He began to collaborate. He began to begin to wield together, to begin to sew together, to begin to weave together the fabric of who you are and the fabric of who he is. And he took the knitting needles and he began to perform the complex action, and he began to tie up parts. He began to say, I need to put this attitude in this person. I need to put these ideas in this person. He weaved it and he tucked it and he pulled it and he put the fabric of him and he intertwined it with the fabric of you, to the point where the substance was not just a pot holder, but it was a purse, it was a dress, it was a sweater. He saw the big picture of you even while you were still in your mother's womb. And it says, you made all the delicate inner parts of my body and knit me together in my mother's womb. You knit me together in my mother's womb. You pulled me together. You pulled the pieces of me together. You pulled the parts of you and combined them and merged them with the parts of me. And we became a new creation, because what we did is that we became a collaboration, and we began to collaborate, and we had heaven begin to meet the earth. We had, oh God, the godly begin to combine with the human, and we begin to see this collaboration that created something beautiful, that created something that might have had some flaws, yeah, but it also had some abilities. He created something that was wonderfully complex. He said, thank you, David said in verse 14. Thank you, God, for making me so wonderfully complex. Wherever you are, whatever it is that you're doing, you might be in your living room, you might be in your car, but I just want you to take a moment, just a moment. You may have never said this to God before, but just in your own way, just begin to express your thanks to him for making you wonderfully complex. It's not a problem that you're complex. It's a solution that you're complex. Thank you, God, for making me wonderfully complex. Thank you, even for those parts of me that I don't understand yet, those parts of me that I've been trying to understand since I was a teenager, those parts of me that I've been trying to understand that nobody else seems to get, those parts of me that cause me to think differently than other people think, those parts of me that cause me to have the hope that other people don't seem to have, those parts of me that cause me to keep on getting up even when I keep getting knocked down. Thank you for making me wonderfully complex. Those parts of me that cause me to keep on wanting to go back to school to learn more. Thank you. I know it feels like a burden at times, but I thank you. Those parts of me that cause me to believe that people can be helped and that people can be better than they are right now, even though other people say you might as well give up on that. Thank you for making me wonderfully complex. Those parts of me that cause me to want to keep on trying even when I failed over and over again, and it seems like the logical thing to do would be to give up, but I still feel this drive, this fire, this passion to keep on keeping on, even though things don't always go the way that I want them to go. Thank you for making me wonderfully complex. Somebody type it, thank you, God, for making me wonderfully complex. David said, thank you for making me so wonderfully complex. Then he said, your workmanship is marvelous. How well I know. Have you ever thought about how amazing it is that you breathe? Have you ever thought about how amazing it is, the process of you taking in oxygen and letting out, maybe it's just me, I know I'm weird, letting out carbon dioxide so that you can live, so that all your levels can be right? Have you ever thought about how amazing it is that you've been able to rise above the challenges of the context that you were birthed into and become greater and become more and to accomplish what others thought you couldn't? Have you ever thought of the amazingness of your complexity? Today, I want you to understand that you are wonderfully complex. He says, your workmanship is marvelous. How well I know it. You know, sometimes we shock ourselves. Sometimes our bodies are able to keep on pushing when it seems like we shouldn't be able to move forward. You are wonderfully complex. His workmanship is amazing. Verse 15 goes on. And he says, you watched me as I was being formed in utter seclusion, as I was woven together in the dark of the womb. Yeah, we've been in some dark places. Has anybody on here been in some dark places before? We've been through some situations that it seemed like wasn't humanly possible for us to get through. The fact that you even arrived on this earth, that you fought the battle of becoming a human being, shows that you're victorious. It shows that you're an overcomer. It shows that you're more than a conqueror. conqueror. Even just to wake up this morning, even just to keep on breathing in spite of what you've been facing, even just to maintain hope, even in this period of life that we've been in with COVID-19, with challenges all around us, you still have hope. What's wrong with you? I tell you what's wrong with you. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. You are wonderfully complex. Oh my, he says, you saw me before I was born. Every day of my life was recorded in your book before I was born. Isn't that awesome? Time is not a match for our God. He has plans for you. He knows the story. You are part of his story. He wrote the story already, and now we are walking it out. Now we are making choices every day that determines what part we play. Now we're making decisions every day that make us a part of his story. Today, I challenge you to choose to make history. You are wonderfully complex. He had need for you. He had a plan for you. He has a plan for you. He has a hope for you. He has a future for you. I'm with it. I hope you're with it today. He says, you watched me as I was being formed in utter seclusion. I was in a dark place as I was woven together in the dark of the womb. Verse 16 says, you saw me before I was born. Every day of my life was recorded in your book. I am an intentional part of his story. I need you to understand that you are an intentional part of his story. Now, will you play out your role in a way that actualizes his vision and his plan and his hope for your life? I need you to know that he does have a plan for you. He does have a will for your life. Your life does have purpose. It does have meaning. There is more to it than just waking up every day and going through a mundane existence until you can get through the end of another week. Your life has more meaning than that. You were fearfully and wonderfully made. It says, every day of my life was recorded in your book. Every moment was laid out before a single day had passed. Verse 17 says, how precious are your thoughts about me, O God? They cannot be numbered. I came to encourage somebody to let you know that you are on the mind of God. You were created in the mind of God. Now you are in the world of God and you are on the mind of God. I need you to understand that he's thinking about you, that he hasn't forgotten about you, that his plan for you has not been severed, that he still has work for you to do. He still has a path for you to follow. He still has something for you to accomplish. He still has history for you to make. Oh God, there's a plan for you. He is thinking about you. He's releasing provision for the vision that he planted in you. He is not forgotten. He'll never leave you or forsake you. He'll be with you until the end of the earth. He's putting your name in the ears of people you haven't met yet. He's creating opportunities with you in mind. He's building buildings through other people that he's planning on you to occupy. He's creating audiences for you. He's creating customers for you. He's even allowing problems to manifest because he's given you the solution. He has made you wonderfully complex. Anybody feel me today? I hope you see it. I hope you feel it. He said in this verse, he said, how precious are your thoughts about me. He's not only thinking about his plan for you, but he's thinking about how his plan will impact you. He cares about your cares. He cares about what you're going through. He cares about what you're feeling. He cares about what you're hoping for. He cares about what you love. He cares about how you feel. I'm here to tell you today that he has not forgotten about you, that his plan for you is real, that he has a hope and a future with you in mind. How precious are your thoughts about me, O God? They cannot be numbered. You're thinking about me more than I can imagine. Verse 18, he says, I can't even count them. You're thinking about me so much, I can't even count the thoughts. You're thinking about me so much that it's innumerable. He goes on to say, your thoughts towards me outnumber the grains of sand. And when I wake up, when I come to a consciousness, when I come into a position of beginning to realize who I really am, tell your neighbor, just nudge them. If you got somebody in your house, just nudge them and say, it's time for you to wake wake up. It's time for you to wake up. It's time for you to come to consciousness. It's time for you to begin to manifest who God sees you as. It's time for you to begin to solve the problems that he has equipped you to solve. It's time for the things that he has knitted together in you and weaved into you as purpose to begin to manifest and to begin to make a difference in your sphere of influence. It's time for you to wake up. It's time for you to come to the realization that your life matters. It's time for you to begin to recognize that you are here to make a difference, that you are here for impact, that you are here for legacy, that you are here to make a difference, not to accept everything around you that is horrible, that's painful to you, but instead to begin to apply your resources, your talents, your ways to make a difference, to make things better, to leave a mark on where you are. It's time for you to wake up. It's time for you to manifest. It's time for you to move forward. It's time. Now is the time. He says, I can't even count how much you're thinking about me. It's more than the grains of the sand. He says, and when I wake up, don't miss this. This is the end of what I got to say. When I finally come to consciousness, it says, you are still with me. Oh my goodness. Isn't that good news for somebody today? Even if you've been living in a state of being comatose, even if you have been oblivious to the fact that God has a plan for your life, even if you have not been cognizant of God's will and plan and hope for you, when you come to a state of consciousness, and I believe today is the day for somebody to wake up. Today is the day for you to begin to recognize, okay, I've got to stop living a meaningless life when I've been called to meaningfulness. Today is your day to wake up. And when you wake up, I need you to understand, like David understood, when I woke up, you were still there. He did not leave you while you were unconscious. He did not leave you while you were living your life in a way that was not satisfying and realizing the plans and the hopes that he had for you. He stayed there right by your side. That's how you made it through that season. That's how you made it through that abusive relationship. That's how you made it through the labels that people tried to attach to you when they didn't understand the beauty of your difference. That's how you made it through the racism, the sexism. That's how you made it through the structures and systems that seem to be designed to keep you down. It's because even through your unconsciousness, he remained with you. He stayed by your side, even through your addiction. Oh my goodness. Even through your addiction, even when you got off course, even when you made decisions that did not resonate with who he saw you as being, even when you were acting like somebody else, when you were making choices that did not line up with who he had called you and planned for you to be, he stayed there with you through it all. Through it all, he's been there. He said he would never leave you or forsake you, and that he would be with you until the end of the earth. He has kept his word. Now it is time for you to wake up and to keep yours. Now it is a time for you to make history. Now it is a time for you to make a difference. Now it is a time for your confidence to come back alive. Wake up, wake up, wake up wherever you are. You can't keep sleeping. Don't sleep. Tell your neighbor, don't sleep on me. Come on, somebody type it. Don't sleep on me. Don't sleep on me. It's time for you to wake up and to manifest the plan, the path, the hope that God has for you, the will of God for your life. You are on his mind. He's making the way straight for you. He's making a path for you. He's making a way for you. He's opening. I told you, he's speaking your name in the ears of people that haven't met you yet. He's opening doors for you that you haven't even gotten to yet, because he knows you're waking up. You're waking up. He's stirring you up. He's shaking you. Today, that's what my job is. My job is to shake you like a mother who's trying to make you not be late for school. Wake up, wake up. You got to get up. You got something to do. You got things to do, places to go, people to see. That's what my daddy says. I got things to do, places to go, people to see, change to make, lives to touch, ideas to manifest, businesses to birth, books to write. Y'all with me today? Degrees to attain, jobs to fulfill, resumes to update. I've got something to do. Lodge, oh God, people to heal. Oh yeah. I got to heal some people. I got to give them some hope where they have been hopeless. I've got a job to do. I have to make an impact. I have to make a mark. Only I can do it in this way. That's why he knitted me together. He weaved himself into me so that I could weave him in to others. And that's your job. That's your assignment. Today is your day to wake up, to allow the magnificent, wonderful complexity of who you are to make a difference in your world, to make a difference in somebody else's world. Today is the day. Today is the day. Wake up, wake up, wherever you are. Father God, we pray now for those who are engaging this message. I'm speaking to the spirits of some people today who have been asleep, who have been unconscious. And my prayer today, God, is that you would begin to wake them up, to bring them to a consciousness of recognizing that you have a plan, a path, and a will for their lives, that you are, or you have already ordered their steps, that you are a lamp unto their feet, a light unto their pathways. Today, I pray that you would begin to let them see what it is that they can do, to see what you have knitted together in them from their foundation, from their formation, that where they've been has been on purpose, that their path of life has been on purpose. Now, because they have traveled the path that they have traveled, there are some people that they can reach that no one else can reach. There's some things that they can accomplish that no one else can accomplish because no one else has had their same experience. So therefore, no one has their same knowledge. We are wonderfully complex. You have put us on a complex path. You have put us with complex traits and complex mannerisms because you have called us to solve complex problems. Today, as we're waking up from our unconsciousness, I thank you that you are with us. I thank you that your word is true when you said you would never leave us or forsake us, but that you would be with us until the end of the earth. And so we're trusting you. Move us forward and let us walk out the plan, the path, and the will that you have for our lives. We thank you, we trust you, and we believe you now. It's in the mighty and the matchless name of Jesus we pray, and we love you with our whole hearts. Thank God. Amen. Amen. Go and get it done. Wake up, get it done. You are wonderfully complex.